Hello all, so welcome back to Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series. So now we will be discussing about the antimicrobial agents which are against protozoal infection. So let's discuss the rapid MCQ series. So in among this section we will be discussing about viral protozoal infection like malaria, leishmania which causes kalaazar, entamoeba histolytica which causes amoebiasis, trypanosoma which causes sleeping sickness and Chagas disease, toxoplasma and pneumocystis infection, and certain other miscellaneous protozoal infection. So keeping this thing in mind, let's start with the first one, that is malaria. So the first question is asking, primaquine toxicity is due to deficiency of. The answer for this question is, remember, primaquine is contraindicated in the patient of G6PD deficiency. Okay, that is glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So let's make a heading about protozoal infection and let's see what are the different protozoal infection and what are their treatment. So let's talk about first malaria. Now remember, malaria is caused by a species, protozoan species Plasmodia. There are five known species, that is Vivax ovale malaria, falciparum and Nolesi. It is due to a bite of a mosquito, that is female Anopheline. So it is a brief introduction about the life cycle of malaria. So when a mosquito bites, the infective stage to human is sporozoite, which is given in the green part. It enters into the liver and in liver it divides. Remember, any stage of Plasmodia which is inside the cell, that is known as schizont or schizogony. So the first stage is pre-erythrocytic or hepatic schizogony. Now in cases of Vivax and ovale, remember, some of these schizont, they undergo into sleep, they become dormant. Sleep is known as hypnosis, so they are known as hypnozoid. This is known as exoerythrocytic schizogony. Now these schizont in cases of P. falciparum, 100% they come into the blood. When there is a free blood stage, free outside the cell, it is known as merozoite. It enter into the RBC, red blood cell. It is known as erythrocytic schizogony. It divides and after a particular time period, second or third day, they rupture RBC, symptoms come and they infect another RBC. Some of them, they get converted into gametes and these gametes, they don't fertilize in human. Remember, they again are taken back by the bite of a mosquito and fertilization takes place in the mosquito. Hence, mosquito is the main definitive host of malaria or Plasmodia. Man is an intermediate host. Now let's see what is the treatment of malaria. Now before treatment of malaria, let's see what are the drugs for malaria. Now drugs for malaria can be divided into fast acting and slow acting. Among fast acting, the mnemonic is Machhar, M for mefloquine, A for etowacone, C for chloroquine group, which contains chloroquine congeners ending with the word queen only, piperaquine, primaquine, tefinoquine and amodiaquine. Then we have halofrentine, lumefrentine, artemisinin derivatives. They are artesunate, artemether, artemether and artirolane. Lastly, racemic mixture of quinine, D and L form. Then slow acting, the drugs can be divided into Plasmodia can die slow or fast, P for pyrimethamine, proguanil and pyronaridine, C for clindamycin, D for doxycycline, S for sulfadoxine and F for fosmidomycin. Fosmidomycin right now is not approved drug. Now let's see the treatment of malaria. In malaria, there are two terms you have to remember. One is cure and second is prophylaxis. So first let's talk about cure of malaria. Cure means we have to make a patient disease free. In cases of Vivax and ovale, remember, there is a hypnozoid stage. So for the blood stage, erythrocytic stage, we give chloroquine for 3 days combined with primaquine for 14 days. When we kill hypnozoids, remember, it is known as radical cure of malaria. Okay, radical cure of malaria. So primaquine plus chloroquine. So primaquine in Vivax and ovale is given for radical cure. While in P. falciparum, remember, chloroquine is not the drug of choice because of widespread resistance to chloroquine. So what is the treatment in India if you talk about? In all states, the treatment for clinical cure is artesunate with sulfadoxine pyrimethamine. And we add primaquine as a gametocidal agent. Okay, here primaquine in falciparum is given as a gametocidal agent, while in Vivax and ovale it is mainly given as a radical cure to kill hypnozoids. While in northeastern part of India, remember, there is resistance to sulfadoxine pyrimethamine also. Hence in northeastern states of India, instead of sulfadoxine pyrimethamine, we give lumefrentine, which is a very important question. And we also give primaquine as a single dose on second day as a gametocidal agent. In cases of mixed infection, वे कंबाइन आर्टिसोनेट सल्फाडॉक्साइन पायरीमिथामिन और ल्यूमिफ्रेंटाइन इन रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट बट वी गिव प्राइमाक्विन फॉर 14 डेज इन दिस केस इन केसेस ऑफ मिक्स्ड इन्फेक्शन गिव प्राइमाक्विन फॉर 14 डेज इफ यू टॉक अबाउट प्रोफाइलेक्सिस ऑफ मलेरिया देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोफाइलेक्सिस वन इज टू किल प्री एरिथ्रोसिटिक स्टेज विच वॉज हेपेटिक शाइजोगोनी दिस इज नोन एज कॉजल प्रोफाइलेक्सिस बिकॉज it leads to erythrocytic stage which causes symptoms so this is the cause of symptoms in malaria that is pre erythrocytic stage there are only three drugs which are approved that is ppd primaquine proguanil and doxycycline then we have suppressive prophylaxis means just to kill erythrocytic schizogonia because they are responsible for symptoms and if we will give erythrocytic schizogonia it will suppress the symptom now the drug of choice is chloroquine especially in on those countries where chloroquine is not resistant remember suppressive prophylaxis is also known as traveler's prophylaxis but if you are going to a country where is chloroquine resistance there we give either mefloquine or doxycycline remember mefloquine is the drug of choice it is given once a week dose is 250 milligram okay so if a person is going to a country it should be started 1 week before and it should be continued for 4 weeks by coming back to the own country Similarly, doxycycline is given, remember, daily. Mefloquine is given once a week, doxy is given daily. Remember, doxycycline is contraindicated. It's a tetracycline. It is contraindicated in children less than 8 years of age and pregnancy. Overall, drug of choice for malaria in traveler's prophylaxis, hence is mefloquine. Now, these are the other approved treatment of WHO, which is outside India. Okay? So, remember this part. Now, What is complicated malaria? Complicated is generally seen by falciparum species. The definition of complicated malaria is the malaria which requires injectable drug or parenteral drug. The drug of choice is artesunate, either intravenously or intramuscularly. Okay? Other options are quinine, artemether and arteether. Arteether should not be given in children. Okay? Now, when a patient starts to accept orally, then we start with a simple treatment. Now, what is the treatment of malaria in pregnancy? Remember, primaquine PHD are contraindicated in pregnancy, that is primaquine, halofrentine and doxycycline. Then other drugs which can be given in second trimester only are proguanil, pyrimethamine and artemisinin. The safest drug is chloroquine and quinine. Okay, the safest is chloroquine and quinine. Now the treatment if you talk about in malaria in cases of Vivex and Ovale, we only give chloroquine. Primaquine is contraindicated. Hence, remember, we don't give radical cure of malaria in pregnancy because primaquine is contraindicated. Why in cases of falciparum, we give in first trimester quinine, second and third trimester same, artemisinin based combination therapy. In complicated malaria in pregnancy, artesunate can be given in all trimesters because the benefit of using this drug is more as compared to its teratogenic risk. Now, prophylaxis of malaria in pregnancy, sulfadoxine, pyrimethamine once a month. Along with folinic acid. Folinic acid is added to pyrimethamine because pyrimethamine inhibits folic acid synthesis. Okay. Now, malaria in G6PD deficiency, remember, the safest drug in G6PD deficiency is mefloquine. Unsafe drugs are other. Primaquine, which was the first option, it was the answer for our first question. Primaquine should not be given in G6PD deficiency. Now, most effective drug for malaria is artemisinin. It is also the fastest drug. And it is also the drug of choice for chloroquine resistant cases. But remember, as artemisinin is the most fastest acting drug, it should never be given for prophylaxis or prevention. Remember, in prophylaxis, we generally give the longest acting drug. Artemisinin is a very short and fast acting drug. Hence, the resistance may develop if you are giving for prophylaxis. Now, if you talk about chloroquine, what is the mechanism of action? The main drug, it enters into the food vacuole and it inhibits the conversion of hemoglobin into hemozoin. The accumulated hemoglobin will kill malaria. Okay. Now resistance occurs to chloroquine because of efflux of chloroquine from food vacuole. The malaria plasmodia throws back this chloroquine outside the food vacuole. Now what is the uses of chloroquine? Remember, apart from protozoan infection, chloroquine is also an immunosuppressive drug. It suppresses immunity. Hence, it is used in autoimmune disease and hypersensitive condition. The mnemonic of using chloroquine is malaria pig. M for malaria, A for amoebic liver abscess, one more protozoal infection. It is given in lepra reaction, a hypersensitive reaction, atopic dermatitis, rheumatoid arthritis. इन्फेक्शियस मोनोन्यूक्लियोसिस, वन ऑटोइम्यून डिजीज नोन एज डिस ड्रग इंड्यूस्ड एसएलई और डीएलई, फोटोमॉर्फिक लाइट इरप्शन एंड जीआरडियासिस. ओके, नाउ द साइड इफेक्ट ऑफ क्लोरोक्विन, रिमेंबर क्लोरोक्विन हैज हाइएस्ट वॉल्यूम ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, इट डिपॉजिट्स इन ऑल ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द बॉडी एंड टॉक्सिसिटी कम्स इन ऑल ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द बॉडी. लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ब्रेन. इन ब्रेन इट कॉजेज सीजर्स एंड साइकोसिस. इट डिपॉजिट इन आई, कॉर्निया एंड लेंस डिपॉजिट इज, रिमेंबर कॉर्निया एंड लेंस डिपॉजिट इज रिवर्सिबल, इट कैन इट सेल्फ गेट्स रिमूव. बट रिमेंबर रेटिनल डैमेज, इफ इट इज गेटिंग डैमेज एक्यूमुलेटेड इन रेटिना, इट कॉजेज परमानेंट डैमेज विच कैन लीड टू परमानेंट ब्लाइंडनेस. एंड द पैटर्न ऑफ डिपॉजिट इज नोन एज बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी बिकॉज इट डिपॉजिट्स इन कंसेंट्रिक रिंग्स. इट इज ऑटोटॉक्सिक. इन हार्ट इट कॉजेज एरिदमिया, क्यूटी प्रोलोंगेशन एंड हाइपोटेंशन, एंड अदर आर सर्टन नॉन स्पेसिफिक साइड इफेक्ट्स. ओके, नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट मेफ्लोक्विन, द मेन साइड इफेक्ट ऑफ मेफ्लोक्विन इज सीएनएस. इट कॉजेज न्यूरो बिहेवियरल एबनॉर्मैलिटी, दैट इज वाई इट इज कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन सेरिब्रल मलेरिया. ओके, नाउ इट इज अ लॉन्ग एक्टिंग ड्रग. इट इज गिवन फॉर बोथ ट्रीटमेंट एंड प्रोफाइल एक्सेस. इट इज सेफ इन G6PD deficiency, एंड द डोज ऑफ मेफ्लोक्विन इज 250 milligrams. Now primaquine, remember it is the most effective drug for hypnozoid and schizont, but remember it is also the most effective gametocidal agent for all plasmodia species, but remember it is not effective against erythrocytic schizogony. It is contraindicated in pregnancy, lactation and children less than 1 year of age and G6PD deficiency. So if you are going giving primaquine for G6PD deficiency, remember it should be given once a dose in every 8 weeks, and we should monitor for hemolysis of RBC. Tafenaquine has recently been approved for P. vivax radical cure. Now quinine was the first drug for malaria. It was obtained from bark of cinchona autumnal plant. Now, if you talk about pharmacokinetic, its mechanism of action is same like chloroquine. It is bound to one plasma protein known as alpha-1 acid glycoprotein. Remember, in fever, what happens? The level of alpha-1 acid glycoprotein increases because it is an acute phase reactant. Hence, we have to give large doses of the drug. Remember, the side effect is it mainly causes hypoglycemia because it releases insulin. Hence, quinine should be given in 5% dextrose. And other side effects are same like chloroquine. It causes block potassium channel on heart, which leads to QT prolongation, hypotension due to alpha blockage. And chronic intake of quinine causes synconism because it is obtained from cinchona bark, which has CNS-like features like headache and seizure, ototoxicity and nystagmus. Okay. Now, remember, these features are also seen with fluoroquinolones as well. The other uses of quinine is it is also given in nocturnal leg cramps, and it is also a class 1A antiarrhythmic drug. Okay, so this is all about malaria. So keep this thing in mind. Let's solve certain questions. So primaquine should not be given in G6PD deficiency, we have written, and the safest drug in G6PD deficiency was mefloquine. Okay, it was the safest drug. So let's talk about now. Side effect of chloroquine are all except. So chloroquine causes retinopathy, it is true. It causes bullseye retinopathy. Bullseye retinopathy means if you will do fundoscopy, this is macula, it deposits like concentric ring. So it looks like a shooting board, which is known as bullseye. It causes arrhythmia, true, because it increases QT interval, which can lead to torsades de pointis arrhythmia. Okay, remember, these are the two side effects of chloroquine which we have discussed. Okay, it does not cause ataxia, it does not cause transquisition. Which of the following is used to treat Plasmodium vivax in pregnancy? Now remember, the drug of choice in pregnancy in vivax and ovale is chloroquine. Okay, while in falciparum, it is quinine. Because falciparum is resistant to chloroquine. Okay, in first trimester, overall it is the drug of choice also. In second and third trimester, you can give the same treatment of malaria, that is artemisinin. Okay, while in complicated malaria, we have to give intravenous drug, IV artesunate is the drug of choice. So this is the treatment of malaria in pregnancy. So the answer for vivax and ovale is chloroquine. And here it is not mentioned complicated, hence go by the answer chloroquine only. Remember, proguanil is absolutely contraindicated. Okay. Now, which of the following is not true for anti-malarial? Now, none of the anti-malarial kills sporozoites. It's absolutely true. We don't have any drug which can kill sporozoites. Okay? None of the anti-malarial, why is it is no, you can refer to the concept whole videos in our series. None of the anti-malarial is effective against all liver and red stage, and the life cycle may coexist in the same patient. Yes, true. Remember, no single agent of anti-malarial is effective against all stage of malaria. Now, in lactating mothers, treatment with most compound is acceptable, but the use of atovaquone and proguanil is not recommended. It is true because proguanil, it inhibits folic acid synthesis. So if this proguanil enters into a newborn, it may lead to folic acid deficiency. Okay. Now, radical chemotherapy with primaquine is necessary for transfusion transmitted P. vivax and ovale. Now, this is a false statement. Remember, transfusion transmitted P. vivax and ovale, it will only contain erythrocytic stage. And against erythrocytic stage, remember, primaquine is not effective. Primaquine is only effective against liver stage. Liver stage were two. One was hepatic shijogoni, which was known as causal profile excess, and second, it is also effective against radical cure, that is hypnozoid. Remember, for blood stage, remember, primaquine is not effective. Okay, primaquine is only effective for liver stage. Hence, for transfusion related, primaquine is not necessary. Okay, so it is not necessary in transfusion transmitted P. falciparum. It is only given for radical cure. Which of the following is not true for chloroquine? Now, chloroquine can be used for RA, rheumatoid arthritis, true. Extraintestinal amebiasis, DLE, lepra reaction, infectious mononucleosis, photogenic light eruption. Yes, we have discussed, true. Volume of distribution of chloroquine is highest, remember. Okay, and half-life, because of this reason, any drug which has high volume of distribution has very long half-life. It is absolutely true. Now, gene CRT of chloroquine resistant transporter confers resistant to P. falciparum. The answer is absolutely true. Okay. Remember, the CRT gene stands for chloroquine resistant transporter. The function of chloroquine resistance transporter is to efflux. This CRT efflux chloroquine from food vacuoles of Plasmodia. Okay, it efflux from food vacuole of Plasmodia. Now, hydroxychloroquine may cause more ocular toxicity than chloroquine. Now, this is a false statement. It is an opposite statement. Remember, chloroquine causes more ocular toxicity than hydroxychloroquine. Hence, hydroxychloroquine is mainly given for rheumatoid arthritis for long periods because it occurs as a long-term side effect of chloroquine. Okay, now which of the following is not true for chloroquine toxicity? In CNS, it causes convulsions, it causes myopathy. It's absolutely true. We have discussed retinal corneal deposit and loss of hearing. Yes, true. Arrhythmia, hypotension, cardiac depression. True. Contraindicated. Remember, this is a false statement. Remember, chloroquine is the drug of choice for malaria in pregnancy. It is the drug of choice for malaria in pregnancy. For which Vivex and Ovale, which are sensitive to chloroquine. Okay. Chloroquine is used in all of the following except, we have discussed a mnemonic, malaria, PG. M for malaria. A for amebiasis or amoebic abscess in liver. L for lepra reaction. A for atopic dermatitis. R for rheumatoid arthritis, AI for infectious mononucleosis, Epstein-Barr virus infection, A for autoimmune disease like DLE, drug-induced SLE, and PG stand for photosensitivity or photomorphic light eruption, G for giardiasis. This was the all uses of malaria or chloroquine. So keeping this thing in mind, you are not finding here the answer as intestinal amebiasis. Here we have written liver amebiasis, that is hepatic liver abscess it is given. Malaria, hepatic amebiasis, DLE, it is not given in intestinal amebiasis. Okay, because it gets absorbed from The upper part of intestine, it doesn't reaches into the intestinal part. Okay. The lumefantrine, we have already discussed, it's an anti-malarial drug. Okay. Which of the following is an inhibitor of epicoplast DOXP isoprenoid synthesis? So it's a new drug. It is under research. Just try to cram this word. The answer is fosmidomycin. Fosmidomycin inhibit epicoplast DOXP isoprenoid synthesis. It inhibit steroidal synthesis in chloroquine, which is needed for making of cell membrane of plasmodia. Okay, mefloquine is contraindicated with, remember, mefloquine and quinine should not be given because both increases the risk of CNS toxicity. Okay, pyronaridine is a new anti-malarial drug which is used in China, not in India. It is approved in China. Even a large doses of malaria, quinine does not produce toxicity. Why? Because high doses of quinine will bind to plasma protein, which will not allow this quinine to enter into the body cells to produce toxicity, because it is highly bound to alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. Which of the following drug can be used for the treatment of chloroquine resistant malaria in children? The answer is, remember, doxycycline is contraindicated in children less than 8 years of age. Okay. It is contraindicated in children less than 8 years of the age. In those cases, it is also contraindicated in pregnancy. So in doxycycline resistant cases, remember, we give clindamycin. Okay, clindamycin. The answer for this question is clindamycin. Okay, even doxycycline and tetracycline are the same drug. Okay, same drug. Remember this part. Chloroquine in large doses causes all of the following except. It causes retinopathy, true. Bullseye maculopathy, cataract, yes. Lens deposit, corneal deposits, true. It does not cause glaucoma, remember. It does not cause glaucoma. Volume of distribution of chloroquine, remember, among all drugs, the highest volume of distribution is of chloroquine. And the volume of distribution is above 1300 liters of plasma. Okay? So this we have discussed in general pharma. The complete concept you can see to the full videos. Which drug is contraindicated in pregnancy? We have written the mnemonic PHD. Okay, PHD, that was primaquine. Anti-malarial, which are contraindicated in pregnancy, halofrentine and doxycycline. These three drugs are absolutely contraindicated in pregnancy. So mark the answer as primaquine. All are correctly matched. About the side effects. Okay. Now, keeping the side effect, remember amodiaquine, A for amodia, A for agranulocytosis, it's absolutely true. It causes bone marrow suppression. Mefloquine causes CNS defect, neuropsychiatric defect. Remember, it causes mental changes. Try to remember like this. Mefloquine, mental changes. Amodiaquine, agranulocytosis. Halofrentine, it mainly causes cardiac conduction defect and arrhythmias. The answer is absolutely true. Okay, absolutely true. And lastly, artemisinin anaphylaxis, it's absolutely true. So the answer is none. Chloroquine in malaria acts on. Remember, chloroquine in malaria is mainly given to kill erythrocytic cycle, which is known as clinical cure. Okay, for all these cycles, remember, we give rather primaquine. Okay, so blood stage, chloroquine. All other stage of liver or inside the liver, primaquine. Quinine is given to the patient of falciparum malaria, causes sweating and palpitation. Now, this is known as, quinine is obtained from cinchona bark. Hena, we have discussed. Okay. Now, falciparum malaria, sweating and palpitation, it occurs due to hypoglycemia. These are the symptoms of hypoglycemia. So, the answer is hypoglycemia. Why? Because it causes insulin release. Mefloquine should not be given with quinine because they both cause CNS toxicity. Okay. Antimalarial of choice in pregnant women in first trimester who is chloroquine resistant is quinine. Which of the following drug is contraindicated in pregnancy? We have discussed PHD. So P for primaquine. The drug of choice in patient with severe complicated malaria was artesunate, IV artesunate. We have discussed. Which of the following drug can be used for the treatment of chloroquine resistant malaria in children? Remember, in children, doxycycline, tetracycline are not given. Chloroquine is also already resistant. The answer is clindamycin. Okay. Bullseye lesion in macula is seen due to? The answer for this question is chloroquine and less with hydroxychloroquine. So A and B. Chloroquine causes bullseye maculopathy. The fastest acting schizonticidal drug among all of the following is. Now the fastest acting drug, I think we have already discussed. The fastest acting drug among anti-malarial was artemether. Artemisinins are the fastest acting drug. Choose the drug whose single oral dose affords clinical cure in uncomplicated malaria by chloroquine resistant P. falciparum as well as Vivex. Okay. So the answer for this question, remember, is mefloquine. Mefloquine is given as a single dose. The drug of choice for treatment of chloroquine resistant malaria is. The answer for this question is quinine. If quinine is not given, the best answer is artemisinins. Okay, but if artemisinins are not given, then your answer will be quinine. We have discussed this part. Chloroquine is given as a high loading dose because of, remember, high loading dose is given for high volume of distribution of drug and long acting drugs. These are the two prerequisites of giving a loading dose. And we know that chloroquine has among all drug highest volume of distribution. Hence, the answer is A. So, why loading dose is given for high BD drug? You can refer to the concept in General Pharma. Radical cure of malaria is caused by. For radical cure, remember, radical cure is given for exoerythrocytic stage. Okay, which is also known as hypnozoid stage. And it is seen with which species of malaria? P. vivax and Plasmodium ovale. And the drug of choice for radical cure is primaquine. Okay, and a new drug is there, but right now it is not approved in our national program, that is tafenoquine. Okay, so the answer is this. So the answer for this question, you will try to find this Vivex and Ovale. Vivex and Ovale is given in option D. Drawback of artesunate is, it leads to rapid recrudescence of malaria. Now what is recrudescence? Recrudescence means incomplete killing. Why it causes incomplete killing? Because it is the fastest acting drug. Because of this reason, always combine artesunate with a slow acting drug. So when you combine artesunate with a slow acting drug, this combination is known as ACT, that is known as artemisinin based combination therapy. Okay, that is why it is known as artemisinin based combination therapy. That is why we always give them in with a slow acting drug. Okay, now a patient is being administered intravenous quinine. He developed restless and sweating. We know that IV quinine causes insulin release because it closes potassium channel on beta cell, which releases insulin. Hence, it develops hypoglycemia. Now, the symptoms of hypoglycemia due to sympathetic overactivity, that is restlessness, sweating, palpitations, diaphoresis, etc. Answer is hypoglycemia. Now, chloroquine is given as a 600 milligram of loading dose. Again, loading dose is coming. So if ever the word loading dose is coming, mark the answer as that it has that. Why it is given? Because it has increased tissue binding. Increased tissue binding means that it will remain in the tissue for long duration of time. It has high volume of distribution. Increased tissue binding and high volume of distribution is the same thing. Okay. Now, radical cure of Plasmodium vivax is done by primaquine. Okay. Pyronaridine is a new drug as an anti-malarial used in China. Which of the following anti-malarial agent is most commonly associated with acute hemolytic reaction in G6PD deficiency patient? The answer was Primaquine. Primaquine is absolutely contraindicated in G6PD deficiency patient. The development of resistance to conventional treatment of WHO has led to recommended the use of combination of therapies containing artemisinin derivatives, also known as ACT. The following combination therapies are recommended if a resistance is suspected, except the answer is artesunate with quinine. So this combination therapy is not given. Okay, they are given separately. Rest all other are given. So I have already shown you the approved treatment guideline. I'll show you again those guidelines, those combination of drugs which are approved. So these are the drugs which are approved. Okay. These are the drugs which are approved. And these are the drugs which are approved. Okay. So artemisinins are never combined with quinine. Now, chloroquine is used in the treatment of DLE, that is drug-induced SLE. We have already discussed. Which of the following is best associated with lumefantrine? That is anti-malarial. If a drug is active against pre-erythrocytic stage of malaria parasite, it will be used as a pre-erythrocytic stage means liver stage. Remember liver stage, hepatic schizogony. I told you in hepatic schizogony, three drugs were effective, PPD, Primaquine, Proguanil, and Doxycycline. And it is also known as causal prophylaxis. It was also known as causal prophylaxis. Okay, I'll show you that slide again. So this was pre-erythrocytic stage known as causal prophylaxis, which is in the liver, also known as hepatic schizogony. Three drugs are effective, Primaquine, Proguanil and Doxycycline. Drug of choice for the treatment of malaria in P. vivax in 25-year-old pregnant female. Remember, normally the treatment of P. vivax is chloroquine for 3 days and Primaquine for 14 days. Why Primaquine? As a radical cure. But remember, Primaquine is absolutely contraindicated in pregnancy. So the only treatment is chloroquine. Hence, we don't give radical cure of malaria in pregnancy. So the answer is only and only chloroquine. Chloroquine is useful in all of the following. DLE, yes. Rheumatoid arthritis, infectious mononucleosis. Now, tissue schizonticide, which prevent relapse of vivax malaria. Relapse means radical cure. Okay. So the answer out here is Primaquine. Okay. Which of the following can cause hypoglycemia? If ever the word hypoglycemia comes in malaria, remember the drug quinine. Quinine causes insulin release. Okay. So the answer out here will be your quinine. Which anti-malarial drug is known to cause neuropsychiatric adverse effect? The answer is mefloquine, most commonly by mefloquine. But remember, it is also seen by quinine also. But most commonly it is seen as a characteristic side effect of mefloquine. Remember, mefloquine produces mental changes. Okay. Absorption of which of the following anti-malarial drug increases with food intake? Remember the answer for this question, food intake. Remember the word, if the food word is coming, try to find F word, that is lumefantrine. Lumefantrine, food increases absorption. Okay, food, fantrine. Try to remember like this. Which of the following anti-malarial is safe for use in pregnancy? The safest drug is quinine and chloroquine. We have already discussed that part. So answer is quinine. The drug of choice for chloroquine resistant malaria in pregnancy is quinine. Okay. Quinine. Which of the following anti-malarial is slow acting? So among slow acting, try to find pyrimethamine. I have told you the drug fast acting and slow acting. Okay. I'll show you that list again. So you are seeing in slow acting, pyrimethamine is written. So fast acting and slow acting pyrimethamine word is written. So go by the answer pyrimethamine. Which of the following drugs is deposited in retina? So retina word comes bullseye retinopathy. The answer is chloroquine. Bullseye retinopathy, chloroquine. वॉल्यूम ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ क्लोरोक्वीन अबव 1300, हाईएस्ट अमंग ऑल ड्रग्स. इन क्रॉनिक एल्कोहलिक पेशेंट विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ड्रग्स शुड बी अवॉइडेड. द आंसर इज मेट्रोनिडाजोल बिकॉज एक्सेप्ट द आंसर इज आस्किंग. द आंसर एक्सेप्ट इज बिक्लामिथाजोन कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड बिकॉज रेस्ट ऑल अदर ड्रग्स दे शो डाइसल्फेराम लाइक रिएक्शन. ओके, तो लेट्स सी द लिस्ट ऑफ द ड्रग्स विच शो डाइसल्फेराम लाइक रिएक्शन इन क्रॉनिक एल्कोहलिक्स. सो द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन वी विल राइट, द फर्स्ट ड्रग इज द ड्रग विच शो डाइसल्फेराम लाइक रिएक्शन इज मेट्रोनिडाजोल. सेकेंड यू विल राइट ग्रिसियोफल्विन, इट्स एन एंटीफंगल ड्रग. देन वी विल राइट सिफेलोस्पोरिन. सो ए एंड बी आर सिफेलोस्पोरिन्स. वी विल राइट क्लोरप्रोपामाइड, इट्स एन एंटी डायबिटिक ड्रग विच कॉजेस डाइसल्फेराम लाइक रिएक्शन. कार्बामाज़ेपीन, इट्स एन एंटी एपिलेप्टिक ड्रग. देन वी विल राइट क्लोफिब्रेट, ओके, इट्स एन हाइपोलिपिडेमिक एजेंट. एंड लास्टली वी विल राइट प्रोकार्बाज़ीन. प्रोकार्बाज़ीन, इट इज अ डेरिवेटिव ऑफ कार्बामाज़ेपीन ओनली. तो ट्राई टू रिमेंबर सी वर्ड, इट्स एन एंटी कैंसर ड्रग प्रोकार्बाज़ीन. ओके, मेट्रोनिडाजोल एंड ग्रिसियोफल्विन आर द दीज ड्रग्स इज द कंप्लीट लिस्ट ऑफ द ड्रग्स विच शो डाइसल्फेराम लाइक रिएक्शन. And if a drug shows disulfiram-like reaction, it should not be given in chronic alcoholic patient. Okay? Now, let's talk about now the next protozoal infection, that is amebiasis. Okay? Let's talk about now next protozoal infection, amebiasis. Now, amebiasis, you know, is caused by Entamoeba histolytica. So it is spread by orofecal route. So this black one is the intestine. The first stage is when Entamoeba histolytica cyst comes into the intestine by oral route. It's a kind of food poisoning. It first remains in the intestine, on the surface of intestine. This is known as luminal amebiasis. Now to kill this cyst, the drug of choice is paromomycin, oral paromomycin. It's an aminoglycoside which is not absorbed. Nitazoxanide, diloxanide furate, tetracycline and hydroquinolone derivatives like quinidochlor and iodoquinol. Now sometimes it enters into the intestine, which is known as intestinal amebiasis, where it causes flux shaped ulcer, bleeding occurs which leads to amoebic dysentery. From intestine it can enter into other organs. This is known as extraintestinal amebiasis. The most common organ is liver. In liver it leads to hepatic amoebic abscess. Now the drug of choice for amoebic dysentery and hepatic amoebic abscess is metronidazole. It is under a group of drug known as nitroimidazoles. Earlier we used to give a drug emetine or dihydroemetine. But in hepatic abscess only, to metronidazole we add chloroquine. So this is the treatment of amoebiasis. Let's talk about these drug metronidazole. Now metronidazole, where it is used, remember the mnemonic is get the gap in metro. G4, it is the drug of choice for giardiasis, either 5 days of metronidazole or a single dose of tinidazole. Entamoeba histolytica, both amoebic abscess and amoebic dysentery. It is the drug of choice for Trichomonas vaginalis, Dracunculus infection, Gardienella or bacterial vaginosis, anaerobic infections, pseudomembranous colitis, now the drug of choice has become oral vancomycin, and peptic ulcer due to Helicobacter pylori. Okay, nitazoxanide, remember it is a P4 inhibitor, pyruvate ferritin oxidoreductase, and it is a drug of choice for Cryptosporidium parvum, where metronidazole is not effective. Cryptosporidium parvum is one of the most common cause of diarrhea in HIV individuals, HIV AIDS related diarrhea. Then we have quinidochlor and iodoquinol. Quinidochlor is also known as clioquinol. It causes a very dangerous side effect. That is why nowadays it is not used. It causes damage to optic nerve. If given for more than 14 days, it can lead to permanent blindness. It is known as SMON, subacute myelo-optic neuritis. Iodoquinol, it contains iodine. Hence, it may lead to hyperthyroidism and iodism like furuncle inflammation of tissues. Okay? So remember. Now, this is the treatment of trypanosoma, African type and South American type. African type of trypanosoma is known as sleeping sickness caused by Trypanosoma brucei, which spread through tsetse fly. South American type of trypanosoma is known as Chagas disease, which is caused by Trypanosoma cruzi. It is due to a bug, kissing bug known as triatomine bug. The drug of choice for Chagas disease is benznidazole. Second drug is nifurtimox. Now, treatment of sleeping sickness is, it is of two type, two subspecies, either Trypanosoma brucei gambiense, which is known as West African type, or Rhodesiense, which is known as East African type. It has early blood stage and a late CNS stage, which is a very dangerous stage. In early stages of West African type, the drug of choice is pentamidine. In late stages, we give a combination of eflornithine and nifurtimox. In East African type, early stage, we give suramin, and late stage, we give milarsoprol. So this is the treatment of trypanosoma. Now, this is the treatment of leishmania or kala azar. The drug of choice for kala azar is liposomal amphotericin B as a single dose intravenously 10 mg per kg. Combination, other drugs are combination of miltefosine and paromomycin, amphotericin B emulsion. So this is the order of preference: miltefosine, amphotericin B and sodium stibogluconate. Then we have post kala azar dermal leishmaniasis, we give miltefosine, but miltefosine should not be given in pregnancy. It is teratogenic. It was developed as an anti-cancer drug. Hence, the drug of choice again is liposomal amphotericin B. So this is the overall summary of the drug for leishmania. So visceral leishmaniasis known as kala azar, caused by leishmania donovani or infantum. So the drugs are SAMP, sodium stibogluconate, resistance have developed nowadays, amphotericin B, which is the drug of choice. Miltefosine is the only oral drug, paromomycin. Other drugs which are not approved are sitamaquine, allopurinol and pentamidine. So allopurinol is also effective against leishmania. Now other leishmanial infections are known as cutaneous, mucocutaneous, diffuse cutaneous, which are sometimes known as oriental sore also, caused by leishmania tropica and brazilensis. Here the drug of choice is sodium stibogluconate. Other drugs are amphotericin B, pentamidine and paromomycin. Not approved are dapsone, imiquimod and fluconazole and ketoconazole. Okay, so we will discuss the treatment of other protozoa like Trichomonas vaginalis. Drug of choice is metronidazole, okay, or tinidazole, and it should not be given topically, and it should be given orally, and it should be treated. Sexual partner should also be treated. Giardiasis, again the drug of choice is tinidazole, single dose. In pregnancy, give oral paromomycin. Okay, nitazoxanide can also be given. Babesiosis, mild cases atovaquone and azithromycin, severe cases quinine and clindamycin. Balantidium coli, tetracycline, isospora and cyclospora, cotrimoxazole. Now treatment of toxoplasmosis, the drug of choice is sulfadiazine and pyrimethamine. Add folinic acid to pyrimethamine. In sulfa allergy, instead of sulfadiazine, give clindamycin. In pregnancy, the drug of choice for toxoplasma is spiramycin. Overall drug of choice, because it prevents fetal transmission, because it gets concentrated in placenta. If fetal infection has occurred, then give the same treatment as above, that is sulfadiazine, pyrimethamine. Okay, both to mother and newborn along with folinic acid. And lastly, this is the treatment of pneumocystis infection, which causes pneumonia in HIV people. So it is one of the most common opportunistic infection after tuberculosis in India. It occurs when the CD4 count falls below 200. The drug of choice for both treatment and prophylaxis is cotrimoxazole. In severe cases, we give pentamidine. In resistant cases, we give clindamycin and primaquine. Other drugs are dapsone, atovaquone and trimetrixate. We cannot add corticosteroid in severe pneumonia. Remember, corticosteroid must be given with them. So this is the treatment of all protozoal infection. So keeping this thing in mind, let's solve the question number 405. Okay, so select the drug which is used to treat antibiotic associated pseudomembranous enterocolitis in and is a component of anti H. pylori triple regimen. Now the answer for this question is metronidazole. Okay, we have discussed that metronidazole is given in pseudomembranous enterocolitis, which is caused by Clostridium difficile. Okay, but remember, now the drug of choice has become oral vancomycin. And H. pylori, yes, in H. pylori we give PPI plus clarithromycin plus metronidazole. So as you can see, metronidazole is given in both of the cases. So answer here is metronidazole. An immunocompromised patient was being treated for diarrhea. That drug interferes with enzyme P4 enzyme, that is pyruvate ferritin oxidoreductase. Immunocompromised diarrhea. The most common cause is Cryptosporidium parvum. Okay, Cryptosporidium parvum. Okay, so the answer here is Cryptosporidium parvum, and this drug is nitazoxanide. This drug is nitazoxanide, which is the drug of choice for Cryptosporidium parvum infection. Choose the most effective treatment for mild intestinal amebiasis. Intestinal amebiasis and asymptomatic cyst passer. So the answer, if intestinal amebiasis has come, the drug of choice is metronidazole. Okay. Asymptomatic cyst passer, you give paromomycin or diloxonide furate. Now the point is, as you can see, that intestinal amebiasis is very mild. So the main treatment you will write here is diloxonide furate. Although this is an incorrectly framed question which was asked once, we will go by the answer diloxonide furate. Okay. Ideally, it should be diloxonide furate with metronidazole. This is the best answer for this question. Okay. The drug of choice for Kala-Azar, remember, LAMP is the drug of choice for Kala-Azar, that is liposomal amphotericin B. Liposomal amphotericin B. Metronidazole is least likely to be effective in treatment of, remember the mnemonic, get the gap in metro. We haven't written pneumocystis. It is not given in pneumocystis. It was a drug of choice for this. Drug of choice. It is also the drug of choice. Now oral vancomycin has become the drug that cleared trypanosoma from blood and lymph nodes. So it is asking about early stage or hemolymphatic stage of trypanosoma and it is also active in late stage of African sleeping sickness is. So the drug answer for this question is milarsoprol. Okay. So the answer out here is milarsoprol. We have also already discussed the late stage of sleeping sickness. All these are the useful in the treatment of visceral leishmaniasis, except we have already written the mnemonic SAMP were effective. Okay. And we have seen the drug. I'll show you that list again. So the drugs for these were the drugs for Kala-Azar or visceral leishmaniasis. That is sodium stibogluconate, amphotericin B, miltefosine, paromomycin, not approved are sitamycin, allopurinol and pentamidine. So the answer out here, which is not given, is hydroxychloroquine is not mentioned anywhere. So the answer is hydroxychloroquine. Okay, rest all other drugs are given, are effective against visceral leishmaniasis, except is hydroxychloroquine. Which of the following statement about amebicides is least accurate? Now, diloxonide furate is given as a luminal amebicidal agent. The answer is absolutely true. We have discussed. Emetine is contraindicated in pregnancy and cardiac disease. Remember, it's absolutely true statement. The main treatment, remember, emetine causes uterine contraction, which can lead to abortion. Plus, emetine is highly cardiotoxic. Because of this reason, emetine nowadays is rarely used. Now, metronidazole has little activity in gut lumen or luminicidal. Yes, true, because it is absorbed from upper part of the intestine. It doesn't reach the small intestine. Now, paromomycin is effective in extra intestinal amebiasis. The answer is false. Paromomycin is only given in luminal amebiasis, not in intestinal or hepatic abscess. In extra intestinal amebiasis, we give metronidazole. Okay. So it is only given as a luminal amebicidal agent. So answer is D. The prolonged use of which of the following drug have been implicated in causing subacute myelo-optic neuropathy? The answer was quinidochlor. ओके, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ड्रग इज लीस्ट इफेक्टिव एज अ ल्यूमिनल एमीबीसाइडल एजेंट? द आंसर वॉज मेट्रोनिडाजोल. इट इज ओनली गिवन वेन द एमीबा एंटर्स इन टू द इंटेस्टीन एंड अदर ऑर्गन, ओनली देन वी गिव मेट्रोनिडाजोल. ओके, ऑल ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ड्रग्स आर यूज इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ एमीबिक लिवर एब्सेस एक्सेप्ट. सो द आंसर वॉज डाइलॉक्सनाइड फ्यूरेट. इट इज ओनली गिवन एज अ ल्यूमिनल एमीबीसाइडल एजेंट. सो आई जस्ट शो यू दैट लिस्ट ऑफ द ड्रग्स अगैन. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द लिस्ट. तो ल्यूमिनल एमीबीसाइडल एजेंट्स एंड इंटेस्टिनल एंड एक्स्ट्रा इंटेस्टिनल एमीबीसाइडल एजेंट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द कंप्लीट लिस्ट विच यू मस्ट रिमेंबर. नाउ आयोडो हाइड्रोक्सी क्विनोलीन कॉजेस, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस, इट कॉजेस आई डिफेक्ट, दैट इज सब एक्यूट माइलो ऑप्टिक न्यूराइटिस. सब एक्यूट माइलो ऑप्टिक न्यूराइटिस. इंट्राल्यूमिनल एमीबीसाइडल एजेंट ऑफ चॉइस इज, द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इज ओरल पेरोमोमाइसिन. ओके, बट द पॉइंट इज इट इज वेरी कॉस्टली. द मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज ड्रग इज डाइलॉक्सनाइड फ्यूरेट. ओके, एज यू कैन सी एमीबी पेरोमोमाइसिन इज नॉट गिवन. गो बाय द आंसर डाइलॉक्सनाइड फ्यूरेट. Go by the answer, diloxonide furate. Now let's move forward. Which of the following is used in the therapy of toxoplasmosis? So the answer was toxoplasmosis. We have already discussed pyrimethamine. So I'll show you that treatment of toxoplasmosis again. So this was the treatment of toxoplasmosis. You can see pyrimethamine is written. Okay, Toxoplasma gondii. So this is the answer. Now, drug of choice for bacterial vaginosis, the answer is metronidazole. Okay, so the drug of choice for bacterial vaginosis is metronidazole. Remember the mnemonic, get the gap in metro. Which of the following is true about the drug used in amebiasis? Diloxonide is used in intestinal and extraintestinal. It is a false statement. It is only given as a luminal agent. Okay. In intestinal and extra-intestinal agent, we rather use metronidazole. Emetine is well-tolerated orally. Remember the word emetine. It is a false statement. It causes emesis. That is why it causes, word has come, it causes vomiting. So it is not tolerated orally. Chloroquine is effective only in hepatic amebiasis. This is a true statement. So chloroquine is given as an add-on drug to metronidazole in hepatic cases also. Mepacrine is used in the chronic cyst passer, false. Remember, mepacrine is not used. Now, a Sudha 20-year-old female developed antibiotic-associated pseudomembranous colitis caused by Clostridium difficile. Which of the following drug is likely to be effective in the treatment of disease? The answer is metronidazole. So, I'll just tell you the what do we mean by Clostridium difficile infection. It's a very important infection for you. So, let's write certain few points in our notes about Clostridium difficile. Now, Clostridium difficile is a cause of superinfection. Now, superinfection means it occurs due to overuse of broad spectrum antimicrobials. When we are using antimicrobial injudiciously, then it leads to infection. Why? Because when you give broad spectrum antibiotics, suppose this is a colon or the large intestine, in our colon we have good bacterias. Now these good bacterias are killed by these broad spectrum antimicrobial. When this good bacteria is killed, this Clostridium difficile may grow out here. Okay, this Clostridium difficile will grow out here and it will cause a disease known as pseudo membranous colitis. Okay, so it is due to overuse of broad spectrum antimicrobial. Now, which antimicrobial causes it? It is due to, we will write most commonly, it is due to third generation cephalosporins like ceftriaxones, etc. But the highest risk is due to clindamycin. But clindamycin is not very commonly used as compared to third generation cephalosporin. Other drugs which can cause are chloramphenicol, ampicillin, tetracycline, and fluoroquinolones. They may also cause. Now, what is the treatment? Remember, the overall drug of choice for the killing of this is oral. Oral word is also important, vancomycin. The treatment of choice for pseudomembranous colitis is oral vancomycin. Okay, but remember, in mild cases and in children, you can also use metronidazole. Okay, now what are the other drugs which are approved? We will write fidaxomicin is a new drug. And we have developed an antibody known as bezlotoxumab. Okay, can we replace this good bacteria? Yes, we can also replace good bacteria. This is known as fecal microbiota transplant. It means replace the good bacteria. It is also known as stool transplant. So it is also approved for the treatment of Clostridium difficile infection. So this is overall the treatment of Clostridial difficile infection. And this is overall about anti-protozoal drugs. So thank you very much.